Sorry for the shaky camera. This is a comparison between a 42AS T-latch by Benchmade. And over here is a Darrel Ralph DDR. They called it a VIII, I think, which I think is the precursor to the current line of Venturi 8s out there. It might be the Venturi 7-2, I don't know. But there literally were four eyes after the V. So I'm guessing Venturi 7 Part 2. Length of the handles are a little shorter on the Venturi. The blade looks like it's about the same size, so it's more compact in terms of the size of the handles. A sandwich style Bali as opposed to a channel on the left. A little bit thicker blade material, I believe. No, it's about the same. This particular one has max glide bearings and it has torque screws, except for this unusual configuration over here. Weight wise, it's pretty light. And I don't have a weight or anything. I'd say God, they're pretty darn close. This is maybe a little heavier, maybe 4.5 ounces is my guess. It's pretty smooth, it's quiet, and action is decent on this particular one. This is unlike the Venturi 8 that I just showed you guys last week, I believe. Let's pull that one out here. Sorry, moving around. Should have been taking that out together. You can see the new Venturi 8 here is a little wider, a little thicker. Wider and thicker between the two. This is definitely a better flipper compared to this thing. I don't know if he went in the wrong direction with this. Definitely should be thinner in the handles when you compare it to, say, a T-latch. There's maybe a millimeter or two difference between the two. Let's put these three together. You can see that the older Venturi here is a lot thinner, a touch shorter. But looking between these two, I definitely think that this is a better one between these guys. But my favorite's still a 42 T-latch. Just to round out the rest of the coverage here, this is a T-latch. It looks like it's anodized. It locks up really tightly, both in the open and the closed positions. It's not adjustable.